Dear students, today we will solve one example in contract costing subject advanced accounting and auditing paper 3 for class SYBCOM semester 4 Veer Narmad South Gujarat University. Here is the question. Bhairav Company Limited is engaged on two contracts R and B during the year. The following particulars are obtained at the year ended on 31st December 2013. Particulars: contract R, contract B. Date of commencement of contract: contract R, 1st April 2013 and contract B, 1st September 2013. Then other details of the contracts are contract price, materials used, materials return, materials on site on 31st December, direct labor, direct expenses, establishment expenses, plant installed at cost, value of plant on 31st December, cost of contract not yet certified, value of contract certified, cash received from contractees and architect fees. During the period, materials amounting to rupees 9000 have been transferred from contract R to contract B. From the above information, we are to prepare first contracts account and number two contractees account. Dear student, this particular sum is from South Gujarat University SYBCOM April 2014 examination. Let us understand the question first. Date of commencement of contract R, 1st April 2013. Contract price rupees 6 lakh. Then material used to contract 1,60,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Materials returned from contract rupees 4000 will be recorded in contract account on credit side. Material on site on 31st December will be recorded as a closing work in progress of contract R account. Then direct labor 1,50,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Direct expenses contract account debit side 66,000. Establishment expenses contract account debit side. Plant installed at cost rupees 80,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Value of plant on 31st December 65,000 will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Cost of contract not yet certified, this is nothing but cost of uncertified work, will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Value of contract certified, this is nothing but work certified, will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Cash received from contractee will be recorded in contractee's account on credit side. By journal entry, bank account debit to contractee's account 3,78,000. And architect fees rupees 2000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side as an expenses. During the period, materials amounting to rupees 9000 have been transferred from contract R to contract B. So accounting entry will be receiving contract account debit to giving contract account. So contract B account debit rupees 9000 to contract R account rupees 9000. Now with this understanding, let us prepare contract R account first. Here is the contract R account. Material issued rupees 1,60,000. Direct labor 1,50,000. Direct expenses 66,000. Establishment expenses 25,000. Plant 80,000. Architect fees rupees 2,000. Then material return rupees 4000 by contract B's account. material transfer from contract R to contract B, ₹9,000. By work in progress, work certified ₹420,000. Cost of uncertified work ₹23,000. Materials at site ₹22,000 and plant at site ₹65,000. Now, by closing contract account, we will get notional profit ₹60,000. And out of this notional profit, profit to be transferred to profit and loss account will be notional profit into 2 by 3 into cash received divided by work certified. That is 60,000 into 2 by 3 into cash received 378,000 divided by work certified ₹420,000. So amounts to 36,000. So out of 60,000 notional profit, profit ₹36,000 will be transferred to profit and loss account, and remaining 24,000 will be transferred to reserve work in progress, and contract R account will be closed for the year. Now contract T's account. In contract T's account, we will record only cash received. Bank account debit to contract T's account ₹378,000. And now by closing contract T's account, we will get closing balance to balance carry forward ₹378,000. Now for contract B, the date of commencement is 1st September 2013. Contract price ₹5 lakh. Material used 60,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Materials returned 2,000 will be recorded in contract account on credit side. Materials on site on 31st December ₹8,000 will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Direct labor ₹42,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side as an expenses. Direct expenses ₹35,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Establishment expense will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Plant installed at cost ₹70,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Value of plant on 31st December ₹64,000 will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Cost of contract not yet certified ₹10,000. This is nothing but cost of uncertified work ₹10,000 will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Value of contract certified, this is nothing but our certified work, will be recorded in contract account on credit side under work in progress. Cash received from contractees will be recorded as a bank account debit to contractee's account. So posting contractee account credit side ₹1,25,000 by bank. Architect fees 1,000 will be recorded in contract account on debit side. Material 9,000 have been transferred from contract R to contract B's account. So our entry was contract B account debit to contract R account ₹9,000. And now we will prepare contract B's account. Here is contract B account for the period 1st September 2013 to 31st December 2013 for 3 months. On debit side, we will record materials ₹60,000, direct labor ₹42,000, direct expenses ₹35,000, establishment expenses ₹7,000, plant ₹70,000, and architect fees ₹1,000. And material transfer from contract R, that is ₹9,000. Now credit side, by material return ₹2,000, and on credit side by work in progress, work certified ₹1,35,000, cost of uncertified work ₹10,000, material at site ₹8,000, plant at site ₹64,000, total ₹2,17,000. Now by closing contract B account, we get balancing figure ₹5,000 on credit side. This is nothing but our loss on contract. My dear students, in case of loss, nothing will be transferred to reserve. but the entire loss will be transferred to profit and loss account, that is rupees 5000, and our contract account gets tally with rupees 2,24,000. Now we will prepare contractee's account. So in contractee's account, credit side, by bank rupees 1,25,000, this is nothing but cash received from contractee, and by closing contractee's account we will get balancing figure rupees 1,25,000 on debit side. This will be carried forward for next year and account close by rupees 1,25,000. That's all. Dear students, thank you very much for watching this video lecture. Very soon we will meet with another example of contract costing. Thank you.